Good morning, everybody. We will start with the last session of this morning, which is higher order masking session. And we will start with a paper from Jean-Sébastien Coron, Franck Rondepierre, and Rina Zetoun on higher order masking of lookup tables with common shares. And Franck will give the talk.
Thank you for the introduction. So I'm going to present you a work on how to evaluate a lookup table at higher order with the help of common shares. First, I will recall a state of the art of the techniques on secure evaluation of lookup tables at first order and higher orders. Then I will present you our optimization, and finally I will conclude. So the most efficient countermeasure against side channel attacks is the sharing principle. To secure sensitive data X, you have to randomly draw 10 T values X1 to XT and build an extra value X0 by combining all the previous value with a given law, which is here the XOR. And as long as you access the shares X0 to XT once at a time, you can securely compute with the value X. So our problematic is given a sensitive data X and a known mapping S, which is represented with a table S, is to securely compute the value S of X. And we will look at the performances when you have L of such evaluations. So at first order, what the known technique is to select to draw M values for a given run of a block cipher, for instance the AES, and this mask value will be common to all the implies X. And at a given evaluation, you have a sharing of X, which is X0 and M, and you want to build a sharing of S of X with by computing a value Y0 and having the M, the mask M, with common with the input value, the input share. So you first compute for all possible values the table T, which consists in unmasking the input, which consists in simulating the unmasking of the input and remasking of the output. And this will be secure at the evaluation because this is done with one evaluation with the help of the lookup table. So this is how we compute the value Y0 by computing T of X0. So this is for the first order case. And when you want to perform such a secure evaluation at higher order, things get more complicated. And we have to wait until 2014 to get a secure solution proposed by Jean-Sébastien Coron. So we have, in this case, all the shares are independent in the input and in the output. You don't have common shares, and the solution were proven with 2T shares, 2T plus 1 shares instead of T plus 1. So I will present you how it works with a short example at the third order given 2-bit values. So say our sensitive value is 2 with a shared representation with the shares 0, 1, 1, 2. So first we compute all the possible output of our mapping S, with a trivial sharing of all those values. You can see that I have selected the 0 masks. Then we consider the first share, which is the last one, why not? and two, and you reorder the rows of your tables. Then you have to apply a mask refreshing. Then you move to the next share, which again reorder the rows of the tables. And again, you have to perform a mask refreshing, and so on and so forth, until you have done all the, you have treated all the input shares but the last one. And with the last one, you don't have to update the whole table. You just select the corresponding row, which is zero in my case. So I just select the first row, and this is a sharing of my output value. And I have to perform another mask refreshing. Why do we have to perform mask refreshing? It's because you, if you don't refresh the rows, you have an attack at order 3. Say you want to say you are looking for a collision between the if you don't perform the mask refreshing, the selected row at the end will be exactly the same at the beginning of the processes of table row computation. And if you detect the collision, then this is a problem. So basically, this is just a rephrasing of the short example at order T. So you have to select, you have to recompute the tables for, you have to recompute two T tables, and you have to do it each time you want to securely evaluate the value S of X, which is different from the first order case where you could precompute the tables once for all the next evaluation. And this is a costly solution. So now we will see how we can have some optimization. So our contribution was first to rewrite all the proofs with only T plus one shares instead of two T plus one shares with the help of the TSNI formalisms. So this saves a factor of 4 in running time. Then we proposed a variant with an increasing number of output shares. I will not focus on this one in this talk. But the idea is simply to have one output shares in the table when we have only considered the first input shares. So the first table is with one output mask, and the second table is with two output masks, and so on until we get fully full output masking of the last in the last table. I will focus on the last techniques, which also save a factor of 2 in running time, which allows to get some pre-computed table that will be used for several evaluation of the value S of X. First, I introduce the notion of common shares. Given two values A and B, we can get a securely shared of these values by only having some shares that are common between them, and this is secure because if you, for instance, probe the value A0 and the value B0, and you XOR them, then you will remove those common shares, but you will have T random mask that will be conserved, and this is secure. So, if we look at our input outputs of the new algorithm, you have a sharing of the sensitive value X with some common mask for all the evaluation, and you have half of the shares that will be independent from one evaluation to another evaluation of X. And we will produce a result with all independent output shares. no command mask in the output. So this is basically the same thing as the original method from Jean-Sébastien Coron. We will compute several tables, but we will do it starting from the command shells to get a command table at the end of the process. So we start with mask M0, then we proceed with mask M, and each time we reorder the rows and we apply mask refreshing until we get a final table TT+1/2, which will be command for all the evaluation. And what will remain to do after that, it's to compute all the tables for the shares that are independent from the command masks. And then you will get the resulting value at the end of the process for half the cost of the original solution. If now we look at the performances we got when applying this technique for the AES and the DES, we can see that for the AES case, we are really faster than the original solution from Coron, but we are not proposing the most efficient implementation because our technique is generic and you can the AES S-box is not a random S-box. It has some structure that can be used to propose the more efficient solution. But in the case of the DES, we can see that our solution is closer to the most efficient one if we compare the first row and the second row. So this is the end of my talk. We have proposed a new S-box evaluation which consider a general S-box. No, we are not focusing on special mapping, and we have done the proof of all our algorithm. This new technique allows us to reduce the running time of the command table, of the construction of the command table by a factor of 2. This is the optimization I have just mentioned with the increasing number of factors, and we can also reduce the running time by a factor of 8 if compared from Coron. For the evaluation of all for all the evaluation, and a remaining task would be to get a process that also propose command shares in the output, which could reduce the cost of the refreshing of all the rows. And this will be another save of factor 2. And this is a solution that can be interesting for generic S-box, especially if the S-box is small, because we have to pre-compute things for all the possible values. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you. We have time for Christian.
Any comment on whether it's a, what are the implications in terms of security of using command shares?
I don't understand.
So is it a good idea to use command shares in terms of security?
Since we have proofs of our algorithm, I don't see the problem of using command shares. I don't really understand what you mean.
No. So There is no implication in terms of security, because so you're reusing randomness, right?
Yes.
So maybe it could be easier for an attacker to learn those shares, since they reappear during
but
the computation.
It's not helping the attacker. As long as the attacker is performing an attack at order T, he won't succeed, even if we are reusing randomness.
All right, even for like multivariate attacks, where you try to use several leakage points?
But you are changing the order of the attack. If it seems that's what you are considering. If you stick at the at a given order, it will be safe to reuse the values.
Okay. Yeah, thank you.
Any other question? I do have a quick question. You mentioned that we need to refresh the output of the tables. I guess you use a SNI refreshing gadget.
Yes.
Could we optimize this refresh gadget, given that we use common shares? Like, could we imagine to refresh only a part of?
Yes, we. That's why I mentioned this in the conclusion. We have fought some improvement to refresh only half of the outputs, but the proofs are more tricky to make, and we haven't succeeded yet to prove an algorithm that, from our point of view, seems secure. This is why we have not published the algorithm.
Would it be much more efficient?
Yes, because you only draw half of the random, and you so it will reduce the running time by a factor of two.
Okay, thank you. No other question? So let's thank the speaker again.